right there. Continuity correction factor. Either minus 0.5 or plus 0.5 because you're going from discrete, which is countable, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, to continuous, which is not countable, it's calculus. So to make the answers comparable, you have to use that 0.5 every time, 0.5. So this 2.5 is what we're after, everybody. So what we're looking for is a normal CDF. And we're going to go from negative infinity, which is to the left bound. 2.5 is the right bound. 5.2 is the mean. And 1.77 is the standard deviation. So let's put that in the calculator. Second bars, number 2, negative e, 2.5, 5.2. 1.77, and our answer is not that far off, 06 something 3 whatever 6. All right, but the answer up there was 058, and I could round it maybe to 06, but 058 and 063, they're fairly close together. They're not exactly the same. The reason is because the n times p is close to 5 instead of over 10. Anyways, this is your n. This is how you do it for number 5. That's number 5. Now let's pick one on the other page. I don't care which. You guys can choose for me. On the next page, it says 100 eligible voters, 18 to 24, are randomly selected. Suppose the Census Bureau says that 22% of them voted. Find the probability band. Okay. So, guys, I don't care which one you pick. Any questions on number 5? Everybody okay?
Do you want us to put the 3 and the 2.5 on, like when we do our graph, do you want us to put both numbers on there? Or just do the one we shape from?
The 2.5 is the most important.
Okay.
Most important.
This one on 305 was even more.
All right. Any other questions on that? Number 5, you got it?
So, I'm going to ask you this real quick.
Yeah, go ahead.
Do you want us to do both ways then for all of
you? I would like you to, but I did not say that you had to.
Okay.
All I asked you to do was that one.
Okay.
Now, the next phase, I do want you to do both ways. 9 to 12. All right, so that's your answer on number 5. This one appears discrete, this one is continuous. This one has a 0.5 continuity correction factor. All right, let's look at 9 through 12. You guys choose, I don't care, 9, 10, 11, 12, it doesn't matter.
About 10.
All right, let's look at the 10 one. And again, I'm gonna do this one two ways. We'll do it with a binomial, discrete, and then we'll do it with continuous. Number 10 says at least 25. Now, I can't write all that out. First of all, there's too many of them. But at least 25, it means 25, 26, 27, 28, dot, 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 through 100. What's the probability that 25 of these age people, 18 to 24, voted, or 26, or 27, or 28, or 29, all the way up to 100, and so at least greater than or equal to, so it looks like this, greater than or equal to 25. Now, you definitely do not want to do this with binomial PDFs. It's going to take you too long for that. So, first of all, let's do our little check. N times P is 100 times 22, which is 22. N times Q is 100 times 78, which is 78. 178, which is 78. Those numbers are definitely bigger than 10, so our answer should turn out to be fairly close to each other. So we can, because this and this is true, use a normal approximation to give the answer. Now, if one of those is not true, or if both of those are not true, we cannot use a normal approximation. But if both of them are true, you can use a normal approximation. You can go from discrete to continuous. Well, we don't want to do 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 5, 5, 5, 100. What we want to do is the complement. The complement is going to be 1 minus the binomial CDF of 100 people, 22% voted. And we want to stop at what number? What number do we want to stop at? 24, because the equal to is up there. So what this CDF does is add, what's the probability that none voted? None voted, one voted, two voted, three voted, all the way up to 24 voted. So discretely, this is going to be 1 minus second large binomial CDF, 100 people, 22% voted, and 24. We're adding up 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way to 24. We got an answer. Subtract 1 minus that answer will give us that answer, which is what we want, the other side. If it goes greater than, you have to go 1 minus CDF. So we press enter, 26, whatever it is, 268. About 27% chance, 27% probability that more than at least 25 people voted out of the 100 between 18 and 24. What is it? There's a giant bug over there. You want me to stop that? Somebody squash it, or you want me to squash it?
Ooh, that thing is like hovering.
Thank you, Cheyenne. See any more of those things coming? All right.
She's like, I had a question, but it totally freaked me out.
She wasn't here that week.
You have to multiply n times p and n times q. Both numbers have to be bigger than 5 before you can use a normal, which I'm about to do right now. This is called the discrete way. The discrete way is the binomial CDF. PDF is either one. But now we're going to use a normal to get the same answer. And there's reason for that in the future. You'll see pretty soon, maybe tomorrow or Wednesday, why we have to do that, okay? But that's the two requirements, n times p and n times q. Well, they're both bigger than 10, so we can say, okay, we can use a normal approximation. This is continuous. It's not discrete. It's calculus. But what we have to do is find the mean, and we know what the mean is. The mean is n times p. N times p is 22, that's the mean. Standard deviation is the square root of npq. Now remember that from the last quiz. If you missed it, I would go over that last quiz and make sure that I would get those correct, everybody. There's 100 people times 22% times 78%, 4.14, if I remember, right? All right, so we know the mean, it's binomial, so the mean is n times, it's a shortcut. We don't have to do that long method. And the standard deviation is a shortcut. So now we can draw a normal curve, but we have to consider that continuity correction factor that we're after. So the mean is 22. We're going to add 4.14. 4.14, and the number we're after is bigger than 25. Okay. All right, so 25 is going to be in here somewhere. I don't know exactly where 25. But the key thing is, it's equal to, there's an equal sign right there. And we're shading to the right. We're shading to the right because it's greater than. If there's an equal to, you go away from the shade 0.5. Well, if the shade's over here, you go away from that shade that way to the left. If it's equal to, you go away from the shade 0.5. If the equal to is not there, you go into the shade 0.5. So in this case, it's going to be 25 subtract 0.5, 24.5. So 24.5 is shaded to the right. Right, and the question is, what's the area under that curve? So the answer is going to be a normal CDF. The left boundary is going to be 24.5. The right boundary is infinity. The mean is 22. And the standard deviation, 4.14. So we've got second bars number 2, 24.5, infinity, 22, 4.14, 273. That's still not that great, but it's not that bad. One answer is 27%, the other is 26.8%. But that's how you do it, by the continuous way instead of the other, okay? All right, so again, binomial to normal has a continuity correction factor of 0.5. If it's equal to, there's an equal to, you go away from the shade 0.5. If there's not an equal to, over here there was not an equal to, you go into the shade 0.5. All right, any questions about 5 or 10? Now we're ready to do our homework for tomorrow. Got that ready. We're going to back up a section, everybody. And this also is going to be used in